true hiker takes 4 to 6 months to hike the 2,100 miles of the trail. A section hiker like me doesn't have that kind of time. So in May 2010, Carmel dropped me off for a 4-day hike. My trip took me from Thornton Gap in Shenandoah National Park to Harper's Ferry, West Virginia, 80 miles in 4 days. On Friday, I did 15 miles to Gravel Springs Hut. You don't really need a map or compass when you're on the trail. Just follow the white blazes on the trees. But sometimes you'll find posts or signs or even old metal diamonds that'll show you the way. Every hiker looks forward to reaching the shelter at the end of the day. You can drop your pack, take off your shoes, head down to the spring and refill your water, and plan the next day. Sometimes you get the shelter all to yourself, but it was pretty crowded on Friday night. Since I'm a snorer, I decided I'd set up my tent. So I had some dinner, turned in for the night. Day two is a big day. Headed north out of Shenandoah National Park, crossing Route 522 and I-66, 25 miles to Manassas Gap Shelter. Saturday was a day meant for hiking. A nice breeze, and the best views Shenandoah has to offer. But soon I had to leave Shenandoah and head down the mountains to where the trail crosses Route 522.
It's in the four or five miles since I've left Shenandoah. We've dropped significantly in elevation. It's 1,000 feet here. It was around 3,000 up there. You can feel it down here. It's a little muggier, a little warmer, a little greener too. Anyway, on I go.
I met some trail maintainers after I crossed 522. Without these volunteers, the trail would disappear in a few years. Hats off to them and Sam, the trail dog. You sometimes get tired of seeing nothing but trees as you hike. So this stretch of open trail near Linden, Virginia is a welcome sight. You can stumble across some history lessons when you're on the trail, but the rock walls and fences you often cross are a reminder that hikers weren't the first people to use this land.
Getting near the end of my last climb of the day. Let me tell you, stretch from Front Royal, where I crossed 522, to where I am now has been tough. Three big climbs, a lot of rocks in one section. You know, all in all, I'm pretty tired. By the time I'm done today, probably about 24 and a half miles, which
home sweet home. And tonight, I had it all to myself. Day three was another long one, about 24 miles north through some tough terrain to Bear's Den Hostel. Making good time and hiking was easy, but I knew what was coming up.
And here we are. I've reached the roller coaster. I have access to the land on the ridgetop, so they have to go along the side. Therefore, you got to go up and down over all the ravines.
The roller coaster isn't the hardest part of the AT, but believe me, it wears you out. Finally, there it was, Bear's Den Hostel, truly a refuge for a weary hiker.
If I look a little different now, like clean, it's because I'm at Bear's Den Hostel. This is right by Route 7, Snickers Gap, Virginia. It's been around since the 1930s. It caters to section hikers, day hikers, lots and lots of through hikers. I've got the hiker's special, which is a bunk, laundry, pizza, Ben & Jerry's, and soda for $27. So after a long day on the trail, it really pays off.
Bear's Den is a wonderful place. After 3 days of living out of a pack, I could sleep in a bed, cook in a kitchen, and sit in a comfy chair with a good book. The walls are a history lesson in hikers, old and new, and you always feel welcome. Day four was the final lap on the Harper's Ferry.
Yeah, there you have it. It's raining. Hopefully it'll stop at some point. Here it is, Monday morning. I got 19.1.
There's not much to see on a rainy day in the woods. Just keep moving and try to stay warm. But I made it to Harper's Ferry, finished my hike, and spent the night with a nice crew of northbound through hikers. All in all, I really enjoyed my 4 days on the trail. I got to see some beautiful sights and meet some pretty interesting folk. I had a great time, and I can't wait to do it again next year.